If you've been watching Bitcoin this year, you're probably feeling a little dizzy. After a year of shocking price swings that left most investors guessing, one controversial model claims to have the roadmap. It's a controversial model called stock to flow, and its anonymous creator, known only as Plan B, has laid out a future for Bitcoin that is too stunning to ignore. We're going to break down exactly what this model is, why it's been surprisingly accurate in the past, and what it predicts for Bitcoin's price between 2030 and 2035. Because in a world of financial chaos, everyone is searching for a map. The question is, can we trust this one, or is it leading us right off a cliff? If you've paid any attention to Bitcoin, you know its price action is not for the faint of heart. It is a gut-wrenching roller coaster. And if you need a masterclass in chaos, just look at 2025. We saw Bitcoin surge to an incredible new all-time high, breaking past $124,000 in August. For a moment, it felt like the sky was the limit. Yet, just as quickly, the market reminded everyone who's boss. By November, the price had tumbled, flirting with lows of around $83,000. This followed a turbulent spring where the price dropped from over $100,000 to around $80,000 in April. This isn't just numbers on a screen. This is the reality that frustrates and terrifies investors. Imagine pouring your savings into an asset, watching it soar, and then seeing a huge chunk of that value evaporate in weeks. That kind of whiplash is brutal. It creates a destructive emotional loop, buying high out of FOMO and panic selling low out of fear. This volatility is the central problem for any long-term Bitcoin investor. How do you plan for the future with an asset that behaves like this? How do you know if a dip is a buying opportunity or the start of a multi-year bear market? Without a framework, without a map, you're flying blind. And Bitcoin's volatility isn't just a feeling, it's a measurable fact. Its historical 30-day volatility is many times higher than traditional assets. Gold, for example, averages around 1.2% volatility, while major currencies hover between 0.5% and 1.0%. Bitcoin has had periods well over 8%. This high-risk profile is what makes fortunes, but it also shatters them. This instability is a perfect storm of factors. You have traders making massive speculative bets, whispers of government regulation, and the unpredictable moves of central banks like the Federal Reserve. It's a chaotic mess. In this environment, investors are desperate for an anchor, a signal in the noise. And it was into this void that an anonymous Dutch institutional investor, known only as Plan B, arrived in March 2019. He didn't just offer an opinion, he offered a model. A model he claimed could quantify Bitcoin's value based on a single powerful concept, scarcity. He called it the stock-to-flow model, and for a while it seemed to be the map everyone was looking for. So, what is this mysterious model that captured the crypto world's imagination? At its heart, stock to flow is surprisingly simple. It's a way to measure an asset's scarcity, and from that scarcity, predict its value. The model wasn't even invented for Bitcoin. It has its roots in valuing precious metals like gold and silver. The name sounds technical, but it's just two ideas. First, stock. That's the total existing supply of an asset. Think of it as all the gold ever mined, or in our case, all the Bitcoin that's ever been created. Second, flow. This is the new supply created each year. For gold, it's what's newly mined from the earth. For Bitcoin, it's the new coins awarded to miners for securing the network. The stock to flow S2F ratio is simply the stock divided by the flow. The number tells you how many years it would take to produce the current total stock at today's production rate. A higher number means the asset is more scarce. Let's use a classic example, gold. There are roughly 190,000 tons of gold above ground, the stock. Each year, about 3,000 tons are mined, the flow. Divide the stock by the flow, and you get an S2F ratio of about 63. It would take 63 years of mining to reproduce the existing gold supply, which is why it's been a reliable store of value for thousands of years. It's incredibly hard to inflate the supply. Now, here's where Plan B's genius and controversy begins. Unlike gold, where the flow can change with new mining tech, Bitcoin's flow is hard-coded and absolutely predictable. And this brings us to Bitcoin's secret weapon, the halving. Roughly every 4 years, the reward that miners get for creating a new block of transactions is cut in half. This event literally slashes the flow of new Bitcoin, making it twice as scarce in an instant. When Plan B first published his model, he plotted Bitcoin's market value against its S2F ratio on a chart. The result was stunning. The data points formed an almost perfect line. The hypothesis was powerful. Scarcity, measured by the S2F ratio, is what directly drives Bitcoin's value. The model showed that after each halving, the S2F ratio doubles, and the price doesn't just rise, it jumps to a whole new level to match the new higher scarcity. It happened after the 2012 halving, the 2016 halving, and the 2020 halving. Plan B's model offered a compelling story. Bitcoin's wild price swings weren't random chaos. They were the market predictably, if violently, adjusting to programmed supply shocks. It turned Bitcoin from a speculative gamble into something you could seemingly measure. The model suggested Bitcoin was on a pre-programmed journey to become the scarcest asset in history, and its price would have to rise to reflect that. This was the roadmap that promised a path through the chaos, and it was too powerful to ignore. For a while, Plan B's model didn't just feel like a theory, it felt like prophecy unfolding in real time. From its publication in 2019 through mid-2021, the model's accuracy was breathtaking. Bitcoin's price didn't just loosely follow the S2F line, it hugged it with an almost spooky precision. Imagine plotting a course on a map and watching your ship follow that exact line through every storm. That's what it was like for the model's followers as they saw Bitcoin track its path from under $10,000 to over $60,000, almost exactly as predicted. The model was forecasting the future, and the future was playing along. The statistical correlation was so strong it was hard to dismiss. Several analyses noted an astonishing 95% R-squared value, which suggested that 95% of Bitcoin's price moves could be explained by its S2F ratio. In the messy world of financial markets, finding a correlation that strong is almost unheard of. It suggested the model had found the primary driver of Bitcoin's value. What made it even more compelling was that other scarce assets, like gold and silver, also fit neatly on the same line when you plotted their own S2F ratios and market values. This implied S2F wasn't just a Bitcoin model, but a fundamental law of value for scarce assets. During this time, Plan B became a revered oracle in the crypto community, his charts treated as gospel. His model suggested an average price for the cycle after the May 2020 halving of around $55,000, a number that seemed absurd at the time. Yet as the 2021 bull run unfolded, the average price came remarkably close to that target. The model gave investors a clear strategy: buy Bitcoin and hold, because its programmed scarcity made its long-term rise seem inevitable. The narrative was powerful and simple. Bitcoin's supply is fixed, and demand was expected to grow. As the flow of new coins gets choked off every 4 years, the price had only one long-term direction to go: up, and not just up, but up by huge, predictable leaps. This period of stunning accuracy is why the S2F model can't be easily dismissed, even now. It demonstrated a correlation so powerful that it forced even the biggest skeptics to pause and ask, what if it's right? It seemed like Plan B had handed the world the ultimate cheat code for Bitcoin. But no model is perfect. And for stock to flow, the cracks didn't just show, they turned into gaping chasms. The prophetic accuracy gave way to high-profile failures that shattered the illusion of a perfect roadmap. The first major blow came in late 2021. Plan B had a floor model that tried to predict the worst-case price each month. After a hot streak, the model called for a price of $98,000 by the end of November and $135,000 by the end of December 2021. The market, however, had other plans. Bitcoin peaked at around $69,000 in November and closed December near $47,000. The prediction didn't just miss, it failed spectacularly. Even Plan B had to declare his floor model dead. The oracle had been wrong. Fast forward to today, late 2025, the model predicted this cycle could take Bitcoin anywhere from $500,000 to a mind-bending $1 million. And where did we peak? Just over $124,000 before tumbling back down. These targets weren't just missed. They looked like they came from another universe. These failures exposed the model's most glaring flaw. It is completely blind to demand. S2F is a supply-only model. It assumes scarcity is the only thing that drives value, but price is set where supply and demand crash into each other. The price action of 2025 proves it. Despite Bitcoin becoming scarcer after the 2024 halving, the price fell sharply from its highs. Why? Because of demand-side shocks the model ignores: macroeconomic fears, regulatory crackdowns, and massive selling from miners. The S2F model has no input for a Federal Reserve decision or market-wide panic. It lives in a clean mathematical bubble while the real market is driven by messy human emotions. As one critic from the Mises Institute stated, suggesting scarcity alone drives value is to entirely spurn the economic realities of how prices are formed. Furthermore, critics pointed out a serious issue of circular reasoning. The model uses the S2F ratio, stock slash flow, to predict market value, stock asterisk price. In simple terms, it's a bit like using stock to predict something that's calculated using stock, a logical loop that many statisticians find invalid. This calls into question whether that impressive 95% R squared was a genuine discovery or just a statistical fluke. But perhaps the most damning evidence against S2F comes from Plan B himself. He has increasingly discussed an alternative framework, the power law model, which models price as a function of time and network growth. The problem? The power law and S2F models give different predictions. For the 2025 cycle, S2F pointed to the stratosphere, while the power law suggested a more realistic peak closer to $200,000. This is a fundamental contradiction. The creator of the roadmap is now handing out a second different map. It's an admission that the single certain path is gone. If you're finding this deep dive valuable, make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications. We break down the structure of this market so you can navigate crypto with confidence, not guesswork. And if you want the full picture each week, the charts, liquidity signals, and macro trends I can't fit into a single video, make sure you join my free weekly market newsletter using the link in the description. Newsletter readers will also get first access to my upcoming macro investing and trading classes the moment they're ready, long before they're released publicly. Your support helps me create more of these high-level breakdowns for you. Let's get back into it. So, the model is flawed. It's been wrong, and its own creator is exploring alternatives. Should we just throw it out? Not so fast. Even if S2F isn't a perfect crystal ball, it's still a powerful tool for one thing: visualizing the staggering long-term impact of Bitcoin's programmed scarcity. It asks a profound what if. What if, despite all the short-term noise, scarcity is the dominant factor in the long run? If we follow the model's logic into the next decade, the predictions get truly mind-bending. To understand the 2030 to 2035 forecast, we have to look at the halvings. The last one was on April 20th, 2024, cutting the block reward to 3.125 BTC. The next halving is expected around April 2028. The reward will drop again to just 1.5625 BTC per block. In that moment, Bitcoin's S2F ratio will double, making it far scarcer than gold. Then, around 2032, it happens again. The reward will be sliced to a tiny 0.78125 BTC. By then, over 99% of all Bitcoin will have been mined. The flow of new coins will slow to a trickle. Bitcoin will become, for all practical purposes, a fixed supply asset, unlike anything humanity has seen before. So, what price does the S2F model predict for this hyper-scarce world? Following the 2028 halving, the model's projection line makes a monumental leap. The range of prices for the 2028 to 2032 cycle is staggering. Some analyses of the model have suggested a future where Bitcoin could target an average price in the millions. One of Plan B's more ambitious models even projected a path toward $5 million per Bitcoin in that timeframe. Though it has already deviated significantly from reality, let's be crystal clear, these are not guarantees. These are mathematical outputs from a model with known flaws. They represent a reality where supply overpowers every other market force. Think of it as a thought experiment. If demand for Bitcoin simply continues to grow, driven by institutional adoption and its use as a hedge against inflation, what happens when that demand collides with a near-zero supply of new coins? The S2F model's answer is a price explosion of historic proportions. By the 2030 to 2035 timeframe, the model suggests that if Bitcoin has survived and solidified its place as a global store of value, its price should reflect its status as the scarcest asset on Earth. Other long-term analysts, while not all using S2F, echo this sentiment, with some forecasts for 2030 ranging from the high six figures to over $1 million per coin. However, this hyper-bullish future hangs on a series of giant ifs. If demand grows, if regulations are favorable, if Bitcoin withstands technological threats, the S2F model assumes all of this away and just says, look at the supply. So, the 2030 to 2035 prediction isn't a certainty you can take to the bank. It's a stark illustration of Bitcoin's potential, the theoretical endgame of its design. It paints a picture of a world where digital, verifiable scarcity commands an astronomical premium. Whether we get to that world is an open question. So what's the verdict on the stock to flow model? It's powerful, elegant, and deeply flawed. In its quest for certainty, it gave us a beautiful story. Coded scarcity is destiny. And for a while, that story seemed true. But its failures have been a harsh reminder that no single model can capture the complexity of a global market. Its blindness to demand, its questionable statistics, and the competing theories from its own creator mean it can no longer be treated as gospel. Doing so is an act of faith, not a data-driven decision. The shocking price swings of 2025 were a brutal lesson. While S2F pointed to the moon, real-world forces of macroeconomics and regulation proved that demand can and does overwhelm the scarcity narrative. And yet, we shouldn't discard the map entirely. While it fails to predict the specific twists and turns, the S2F model provides a compelling thesis for the final destination. It crystallizes the core value of Bitcoin, its absolute, verifiable scarcity. In a world where governments can print money without limit, an asset with a fixed supply of 21 million is a revolutionary idea. The model's long-term predictions aren't a promise, but a possibility. They are a glimpse into a future where scarcity becomes the dominant force. It forces us to ask the right questions. What is the true value of absolute scarcity? And what happens when a world of investors begins to seriously compete for a dwindling supply of new coins? Ultimately, the stock-to-flow model isn't a crystal ball. It's a tool for thought. It highlights the single most powerful attribute of Bitcoin. The journey will be volatile, but the model suggests that with each halving, the fundamental gravity of scarcity will keep pulling the price upwards over the long arc of history. It's a prediction you shouldn't ignore, not because it's guaranteed to be right, but because of the profound truth it tries to capture. But that's just our breakdown. The crypto community is fiercely divided. Do you believe the stock-to-flow model is a reliable roadmap or a flawed prediction that's been definitively broken? Let me know your take in the comments below. And if you enjoyed this analysis, don't forget to like and subscribe for more deep dives into the world of crypto.